Hello everyone, I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library, and in this Tinkershop tutorial, we're going to learn how to design a family tree. Now this will be cut in our laser cutter, but let's get started. Begin by opening up your Inkscape program. In the center here, you will notice a square, and this is known as your canvas. Anything you design inside this canvas will be captured, but anything you put outside of the square will not be captured and will not be recognized by the program. So the first thing I like to do is measure my document properties. What I'm going to do is go up to the File menu, click on Document Properties, and I'm going to change my display units to IN for inches, and I'm also going to do the same for my units. Now in my width and my height, I'm going to use a full sheet of wood. So I'm going to type in 24 for width, and I'm going to do 11.5 for height. Okay, you'll probably notice that your canvas now, I'm going to close this window. You're going to notice that your canvas now has changed. So virtually, it is actually 24 inches by 11.5. Anything that you design within the space will be scaled as it would be in real life. Next, we are going to import an image. So we're going to go to Google and we're going to look for some tree silhouettes. Go to your Google icon, open up a new window, and type in tree outlines or black and white or silhouette. Now when looking for a design, we want to find something with very hard lines, that's something thick, and something that is not going to be too fragile when it gets cut in our laser cutter. So I found my image. I'm going to right click on top of it, click Save Image As. I'm going to save it to the desktop, and then I'm going to go back into my Inkscape program by clicking on that. The next step is I'm going to import my image. So I'm going to go up to File, Import. And then I'm going to click on my image and I'm going to open it. Click OK. And you can see we have our image here. I'm going to use my arrows and click and drag. I'm going to make this a little bit bigger. We want it to be as big as possible. Now we're going to convert it to a vector file. We're going to go up to the Path menu and click on the third option down. It's called Trace Bitmap. This new window will appear and it's automatically set to default. So if you click Update and click OK. It doesn't look like anything's happened, but you actually have two. Now, which one is your good image and which one is your not good image? Click on your Edit Path tool. If you click on this one, you notice there's no red lines coming up and there's no nodes. But if you click on this one, you've got all the nodes. Okay, so we know this is our good one. This one, we can select it and delete it. There is some lettering down here at the bottom. I don't want those. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my Edit Path tool, and I'm going to click and drag a square around that text. It's now highlighted, and all I have to do is hit Delete. Now it's removed. We're going to make this a little bit bigger, and we're going to zoom in. And right now it has a fill. What we're going to do is we're going to remove this fill. So we're going to go over to our Fill and Stroke, with you under Object, and click Fill and Stroke, and this will bring up a new menu. We're going to remove the fill from that by clicking this X. We're going to click on Stroke Paint and add a stroke by clicking the solid square. You'll notice now it is just an outline of your object. This is what we want. Our next step is we're going to be creating some text. So let's click on our text tool, and I'm just going to select anywhere on the page, and I'm going to type my name out. When you're doing this, it is best to choose fonts that are more script or in cursive. So if you want, you can go over to the right-hand toolbar, and there's a text tool by clicking on this T, and it'll bring up a menu of different fonts. Just scroll through, and let's find something that has more cursive style to it. Once you've found your text, you can click Apply. I'm just going to make our text a little bit bigger. Okay, now that we have our font, we're going to place it on one of our branches. You can see that these branches here have some leaves. We're going to remove those leaves, and then we're going to put our letters on top of it. So we're going to use our edit path tool, click on it, select your tree, and you can see these gray dots, and they're called nodes. They control the lines of the object. So I'm going to just make a little square around here and delete it. I'm going to do the same over here. Also delete it. Now you can see it kind of gets a little bit wonky here. And you can adjust them by moving them up or down. Go up to the toolbar here and you can click some of the options. Okay, so we're going to put Rachel up on this line. Now I'm going to click on my move tool and I'm going to select the name, but I'm going to do the same thing that we did for the tree. I'm going to remove the fill on it. So I'm going to go over to the fill and stroke, fill tab, click on the X. I'm going to go to stroke paint, use stroke only. And then I'm going to just rotate it, line it up, zoom in just so you can see it a little bit better. I'm going to remove this one leaf. Okay, so we're going to move our name and we're just going to overlap it just a little bit here so you can see that. So I'm going to select my name, hold down shift and hold the tree. I'm going to go up to the path menu and I'm going to select union. Now we can see now my name is fully attached. Let's do that one more time. We're going to look at one of our branches here. And you know what? Let's remove this branch. We're going to go back up to our edit path tool. And we're going to just click and drag a box around these objects. We're just going to delete these nodes because we're going to make room for our next name. I wanted to create another node, just double click on that line and you can kind of bend it here. Okay, so our next name is going to go right here. We're going to go back up to our text tool, click on it. I'm going to type in our name and then I'm going to switch it to the same font style that we just used. So I'm going to go back over to our right hand toolbar, click on the T, and I'm going to move it up onto our branch. I'm going to click on it a second time just so I can rotate it. And again, I'm going to double check everything because I wanted to make sure that this is still going to be combining. We're going to click on our fill and stroke. We're going to click on the fill tab, click the X. There's no fill. Click on our stroke paint and click the solid square. Again, I'm just going to adjust where these lines are going to go. I'm going to select my tree, hold down shift, select my name, go up to the path menu and click union. I wanted your name to go with the branch, kind of more along it. There's a way of doing that as well. Type your name out, click on your text tool and type your name. It does not have to be a cursive font this time, but you're going to do a couple of extra steps for this one. You're going to go up to the path menu and click object to path. You're going to move your name now and as you can see it's all in different separate pieces, and if you click on it a second time you can then kind of move your letters around. So I'm just going to move it down a bit, move this one. Okay, when they're all lined up on your branch, you're going to do the same step as before. If that didn't work, try using your edit path tool for that one. So hold down shift, click, click. And then go up to path and click union. They should all be connected now. Now, if that was a bit too advanced for you, there is one more option where you can engrave names onto your tree. You can either just use your text tool, click on it. You can move your name to wherever that branch will fit onto it. So you can put it in place here, and as long as it does not have a stroke and it is only fill only, it should engrave. There's another option where you can bring in another object. So I'm going to bring in a leaf, and I'm going to attach a leaf to the branch here on our tree. So I'm going to go to File again, Import, find my leaf. I'm going to open it, click OK. I'm going to do the same steps as before when we first brought in our first tree. I'm going to go to Path, Trace Bitmap. I'm going to click Update, and I'm going to click OK. Okay, so I have a leaf here. I'm going to make it a little smaller, and I'm just going to move it kind of where I would like it to fit on my tree, because I'm going to make a couple of these. I'm going to take the stem of this leaf, and I'm just going to put it kind of mixed in the branches here. So I'm going to just attach a little bit here. Same thing as combining them. I've selected my one object. I'm going to hold down Shift. I'm going to select my tree. I'm going to go up to Path, and I'm going to click on Union into the space here, and that way it'll engrave on this leaf. And again, you can do that for a couple of different ones. So let's add another one. I'm just going to put it at the end here. Same thing. I'm going to hold down Shift, select my tree, go up to Path, and click Union. So now I can make a copy of my name if I wanted to. Now lastly, we're going to set a cut line. So I'm just going to click on my tree. I'm going to go over to my fill and stroke, and I'm going to make sure there's no fill, so there's no infill color. I'm going to click on stroke paint. There is a stroke, and then I'm going to go over to stroke style, and I'm going to set this to our cutting number, and it's a specific number, so it's in inches. And I'm going to type 0.001. Any other number will actually get it to engrave. So let's just zoom in. You can still see it here. And you can see our other names here because they're meant to be engraved here. And lastly, we're going to save our file. We're going to go up to the File menu, click Save Image As, and we're going to save it as an SVG, an Inkscape file. I'm going to save it a second time, but I'm going to save it as a different format. So I'm going to be going up to File, click Save As, but this time I'm going to click this drop-down menu. I'm going to select PDF, a portable document format. I'm going to click Save and click OK. And you've just learned how to design a family tree to be cut in our laser cutter. Thank you for joining us in today's Tinker Shop. I'm Rachel from the Innisfil Idea Lab and Library. Thanks for coming.